Hello, grooming lovers. It is Damjan from Man's Best Friend channel, and today we have this lovely, super lovely girl. Her name is Charlie, and she was here before. I know that she's a great dog, and the owner wants her short completely. I was going to start by clipping her nails. Okay, so looks like this nail is broken. Okay, just a little bit. It can happen that dog's nails break when they're too long. It can be painful for the dog and unpleasant, because every time they step on that feet, it's going to hurt. So to avoid that, check your dog's nails. If they're long, take them to a groomer or to a veterinarian. And it will decrease the chance of a nail getting broken. Okay, so when that is done, I'm going to take the 8.5 blade. Okay, I'm just going to oil it. Yeah, she's being spoiled right now. I just left her for 2 seconds and she started whining. Okay, I'm just going to start shaving her. Okay, girl. I'm going to shave her once and then I'll give her a bath and then I'll shave her again to make it all nice and even. You always have to shave the dog again after the bath because some hair will always fluff out, make it uneven, and you don't want that. Okay, I want to spray this blade a little bit with a spray that cools, lubricates, and then zipacks the blade. See, that is the one. So today is 25th June, and as I said, in the next 2 months I'll be about 1 month out from grooming, because I'll be traveling. Yeah, this is a template for the inside part of the of a new shell. Okay, girl. Actually, okay. Okay, girl, okay. Okay, girl. And I really love this dog. She was adopted by a family who take great care of her. And she really got to great hands. And she's a happy dog. Okay, let's do her stomach. Okay, go. Hey, there you go. Okay, so this is a 30 blade, about 1 millimeter long. I'm going to do her paw pads. I mean, shave this hair between the pads. Makes the paws easier to clean, to maintain. And less slippery, and also if this hair gets matted, it can be really unpleasant and painful for the dog. First one is done. Also, the foxtail plant can get into those paws. I mean, it's easier to spot. There's something like that. See how clean it looks right now. Okay, so this blade got warm. Put it back on. Okay, girl. Guys, again, sorry for not talking too much. Since I'm going on a trip in like 5 or 6 days, I've been working a lot to, you know, make all the customers happy. And to fix some things about my car and to get some papers for traveling, something like that, and to finish some things in a bank for my salon and for YouTube and stuff. So if I'm not working here in a salon, I'm doing stuff and working out. out of the salon. So that's what owning a business is. For example, if you work 8 hours in your salon, that does not mean that you're working 8 hours a day. You have to clean your salon, you have to wash your towels, you have to clean the table, you have to disinfect the blades, you have to clean the bathtub, you have to clean your bathroom that you're using, you have to go to the bank, you have to fill up all these forms, you have to get the shampoo, get those paper towels, the ethanol for disinfection, a lot of things. And when you're not working, if you are finished with your shift, so a lot of the times the customers are going to call you after that. And owning a business, it requires time. So of course you're going to make money if you have your own, more money if you have your own business. But honestly, I totally get people that do not want to have their own business, that are just satisfied with working in someone else's company or salon or whatever. They are going to make less money, but they're going to have more spare time. So that's it. If you want to have a business, also with YouTube, you know, although my girlfriend helps a lot with YouTube and everything, it still is a lot of work. I don't like complaining, but you have to charge the batteries for a GoPro, you have to prepare the salon for filming the groom, and there is stuff to do. Okay, so I did everything before the bath. I'm going to give her a bath now. Sorry, I'm not going to film that because my GoPro is very, very warm and I don't want to risk to overheat it. So I'm just going to stop, cool the GoPro, give this lovely girl a bath, dry her up, and then I'll see you after that. Okay, so I finished bathing her and drying her, and actually I'm going to start with shaving her head. Okay, I'll just turn off the air condition a little bit. Okay, go. This is a tan blade again. Okay, I'm going to scissor the edges of the ear. Okay, so her head is done. Okay, I'm going to do her sanitary area. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now I'm going to continue shaving her with the 7 blade. Make it all nice and even, but first I want to turn on the air condition. Come on, Charlie. So this side is looking better and better. okay. That leg looks fine. I'm going to take the scissors. To scissor around the paws. So because this blade got warm, I'm taking another one. Okay, girl, you're okay. Okay, guys, we are done. You can see it all looks nice and even. And actually I accidentally pressed the picture mode and I didn't film one part of the groom. I just realized it. Sorry about it. I hope that it was not a large part. And I'm going to put her down now because she is done. And sorry again. Let's see, she's a happy dog. She's not afraid anymore, which is great. And that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching this video and supporting me. I hope you enjoyed. And I will definitely see you soon. Bye.